Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on Final Fantasy 15. We need to go meet Monica at the Prairie Outpost, so let's head on over here and talk to her.
Your Highness, the Marshal has apprised me of the plan. We've found a back door into the Imperial base. I'll mark the route on your map. The way is secure. You should be able to gain entry relatively easily.
Alright, so let's head out. I turned the audio up for the voices as well as everything just a little bit. It seemed like my voice was a little bit louder through the first three episodes. Not anything terrible, like, it wasn't like, it wasn't like you couldn't hear it or anything, but I think it was worth turning it up a little bit. So let's go ahead and collect this elemency real quick. Alright, so let's get a 99 potency here. We already have 99 potency fire, so we're gonna have another one. I could do some of this stuff, but I feel like I just don't have enough to do it. It creates the heal cast, but I think I would much... Let me just back out of this. There we go. Alright, so let's create the fire. We're almost able to create lightning. Let's go ahead and create that. And store it. Not used to having only three, so I'm gonna fill up here relatively soon. We'll go ahead and just travel here at night. I think we should have to worry too much about...
So, who is this Monica person?
A servant of the Crown's Guard, like Gladio and myself.
She's one of my father's best, along with Dustin, who's guarding my sister.
Good to know we still have people we can count on outside the city.
No room for error.
We're gonna go ahead and just avoid those level 1 Reaper tails. Not gonna be worth too much experience, so not really worth the time, I don't think, to fight them. They're like level 8 Reaper tails or something like that. I'd probably fight them, but at low level, think best to just ignore them.
Imperials above us!
Thanks.
Where are they? I actually don't see the Imperials. Oh, they're way over there. Okay, we're not going back to fight them. I thought they were gonna drop. Usually they drop, like, right on you. Huh? Alright, I think we need to come over here. There is a campsite over there. Here we go.
From here, we will split into two groups. Prince Noctis, please join the Marshal up ahead. The rest of you will assist me in the diversionary effort.
All right, let's go.
Well, see you guys later.
You go give them hell. We'll do the same on our end.
I hate splitting up in this game simply for the purpose that then your EXP isn't even through all your characters. You get characters leveled ahead of others, so that's the only thing that annoys me about it. Other than that, it's fine. And it's really not all that big of a deal, I don't know. There's a part of me that just likes having all my characters same level, same XP gained, same XP needed, just all level up at the same time.
Once we're in, we launch our ambush, pushing out while support pushes in, crushing the enemy from both sides.
Alright, let's go. I don't think there's all that much combat here, anyway. This isn't one of the big scenes where you're split up and you really level up ahead of the other person. Let's get up there. And see, with this, not that we're terribly over-leveled, but we are a lot higher level already than the enemy, so even when I try to progress through this a little bit quicker than I did initially, I think it was like level 12 or something by now, at least. Alright, I'm gonna start looking into...
Don't get used to it. I'll be gone before you know it.
I'll enjoy it while I can.
Above us! Got it.
I will start checking in here soon about trying to get it more figured out exactly when it's coming out. I didn't see an exact release date when I was initially looking at it, so... Crap. Die here. Or would you do something and help me? But I don't wanna... I wanna try to finish this up relatively close to when New Game Plus comes out, so that I can start uploading that as soon as possible. I may even do them. Okay, so this perk gets annoying if you don't have any MP. And I didn't go. Oh my gosh. Alright. Let's do this. This part's so annoying if you don't get up top. Dude. But I may even. Man, I go through my MP so fast. I don't want to keep wasting elixirs like this on this part.
Whoops. Never mind. Focus on the battle. Yeah.
Alright, dude. Alright, we're gonna kill him here in a second, but if it. Oh my gosh, I only get like two strikes out of this. Alright, well, that was a waste. Oh no, wait, he actually hit them with that. Okay. Dude. Oh my gosh, you got teleported up top. Well, that was helpful. But like I said.
So it should be. Otherwise, you'd only get in everyone's way.
Could have gone it alone if I wanted.
That mentality could prove your undoing, Linus.
Okay, but like.
Be all right on their own?
Worrying will only compromise your focus.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, like I was trying to say, I will. Probably just split the uploads when that comes out if I'm not finished with this yet. If anything else. Okay, let's try to. Oh, there is a warp point up there. I'm stupid. Hold on. There we go. I hate fighting these snipers when there's a ton of them, especially when they're far apart. Because they can so easily, like, stunlock you. See, I'm stunlocked. And then I got teleported back down. I'm here. Once I kill one, I keep locking onto the stupid axe. And I didn't get up. Okay, let's just fight. Or what are you doing? What is he doing? Dude, he's glitched in the wall. Or no, wait, he's glitched. He's glitched in the corner. What is this, dude? And I don't have enough MP to get up there, so let me put this on. Let me kill this. Okay, I'm gonna try to use his techniques to get him out of the corner. Thank you. Use it again. And use it one more. Use it. Go, now he's vulnerable. Ah, stupid snipers, dude. Literally drive me insane. Come here. There we go. Alright, let me open the door. Wish the action button was more responsive than it is. You end up jumping more than you actually do the action that you're wanting to do with the A button.
Not!
Marshall, it's good to see you again.
All right on your end?
Right as rain. The Nifs couldn't take their eyes off us. Thanks to you, we were spared their attention.
Stay right where you are. Well, well, if it isn't Kor the Immortal. So, you survived the Citadel. But you won't survive what I have in store for you. It's past time your legend came to an end.
guy literally sounds like a little kid. I forget what TV show he sounds like he's from where it's actually is a kid. I hate that there are snipers in this. If there were not any snipers in this.
What's the plan, Ignis?
Prepare ourselves for the long haul.
Gotcha!
This would be easy. It's not bad, but that's annoying. I need them to get up here so that it'll lock on to them instead of me. Come here. Take care of these snipers. Hopefully they take care of everything else down there. But I doubt they will, because they never do. Okay, three snipers down. And here goes the fourth. Alright, let's have Ignis mark. Not really what I... Okay, there we go. As long as he doesn't completely just mark one target, because that's not what I want him to do. Okay, is it just... Okay, it's just him. I'm gonna use Corey's ability. I don't think Core's ability is very good. I don't know, now this is just a matter of time. It's not really that hard of a fight against him. It's just kind of a time thing. Oh, a blindside link. What is it doing? This is really weird. It's like it was glitched. Why was it walking around like that? Warp strikes, get some bonus damage. There we go, vulnerable. Okay, I am using up all my health here. Let's do that. He stays down forever in this, which is nice.
Say your prayers. This can't be happening. In the name of Nibelheim.
Alright, let's have Prompto shoot. Really not doing any damage. Be better off just to use my... Alright, he's dead.
Glory! Yeah! To the Empire!
Hell yeah!
Impeccable.
Grab that item real quick before the cutscene.
Impressive. Seeing you in action puts my mind at ease. It's clear I don't need to worry anymore. I'll return to watching the NIFs. Till next time, take care.
Not bad experience, and I believe that's the end of Chapter 3. Or maybe it's not.
Ain't so bad out here once you get used to it.
Still a lot we haven't seen, though.
And a lot for us to do.
Yeah.
Buck up. We're just getting started.
No, that is the end of Chapter 3. Should have never second-guessed myself. Well, what level do we get to? Level 9, not bad. No, level 10. Almost 2 to 11 and 2 close. See, that's why I don't like getting off experience. I'd rather just have us all be level 11. Alright, what new pictures do we have? Let's get that picture. That's not a bad one. That's not a bad picture either. We'll stop at that. But now we head into Chapter 4, I think I'll, or Chapter 3, we head into Chapter 3, that was the end of Chapter 2. And I think I'll just leave this in, I'm not going to cut it at 15 minutes, we'll continue this episode and continue into Chapter 3. Can't always be perfect and end it right at the end of the chapters, and I think a 15 minute video is a little short, so we'll keep on playing. We're into the open world, I believe. Actually, I'm not even going to guess. We're getting to Lestalum here soon, which is obviously where I'm going to do pretty much the only side quest that we're going to do. And so, looking forward to that, looking forward to getting some money to be able to get some potions so that we can be decently stacked up, as well as be able to use some different stuff like that in making of Elemancy and stuff like that. So I am looking forward to being able to use some of that and getting more charges for my Elemancy. That'll be nice. But other than that, nothing too exciting coming up. Doesn't really pick up for another couple chapters. This is still kind of... This game's a little weird. The story's kind of a little weird to follow if you're doing all the open world quests and you're doing all the side and hunts and all that different stuff. You kind of get lost in what on earth is happening in the story. But I think in this it'll be a little bit easier to follow since I'm not doing too many side quests and we're not getting too distracted. When I do that New Game Plus, and I think I'm going to try to do a decent chunk of the side quests, I think we'll get a little lost in the story, and then you kind of just really run through it. I think it's like chapter 4... I think it's chapter 5. Chapter 5 to chapter 15. You just kind of blow through them. After you've completed pretty much all the side quests, so that's kind of it's kind of a weird design to the game, because you can literally do almost every side quest here.
So, the prince eludes death. And what of the elusive ring?
Eluna Freya has absconded with it.
Find and kill her. The ring is the final piece.
We may do well to take her alive. The Six wield power beyond our imagination. The Oracle holds the key for the King. She could unlock many secrets. Nay, High Commander. Lord Ravis, the Imperial Army is now at your disposal.
A moot point, while the fugitives remain at large. My men and I will continue our search for the Prince and the Oracle.
So glorious. My crystal.
Look out, world! Here we come!
We can finally leave this dust bowl behind.
The lands beyond are vast by comparison to lead.
Bigger's better! More stuff to see and do!
First comes to Sky, a region known for its wetlands.
Really? Wetlands?
There's also a chocobo forest.
Now we're talking!
Further west lies the Klain region, wherein we'll find the town of Lestalum.
Oh. Isn't that where Iris is headed?
Barring delays, she should have arrived by now. Maybe even had herself a look at the meteor.
The meteor of the Six?
The same. Its heat is harnessed to power, Lestalum.
Whoa! That sounds way cool!
I'm actually looking forward to this.
Got a little pit stop for some gas.
Let's fill up the tank before we set out. I believe we have a solid lay of the land now. The driver's seat is yours, Noct. If you so desire it.
Alright, Noctis can now drive the car whenever I want. Alright, I think I have to run away.
Who could this be?
Yeah, there we go.
Hello?
Noct?
Iris?
It's really you! So good to hear your voice. Everything's fine over here. We managed to make it to Lestalum. We just settled into our new digs. So yeah, let me know when you're coming so we can meet up.
Yeah, will do.
You better.
Was that Iris? Can't even call her own brother.
In all fairness, yours wasn't the obituary broadcast all over Lucis.
What about me? She say anything about me? Did you see that sign? Chocobos! Chocobos!
No time for that. Need to get to Lastalum.
It's still ages away. Come on, just a quick visit.
We're gonna go to the Chocobo post because I want to have those unlocked. Because, actually, I'm not gonna spoil anything, but I want to have the Chocobos unlocked.
Sure, let's check it out.
Yes! Gonna be awesome!
Oh good, I'm great. I'm glad it tells you what a side quest is if you couldn't put two and two together and figure out what side quest stood for. Alright, I should be able to refuel now. Yep.
Huh?
We're still extremely poor. I don't know why at the beginning of that cutscene it glitched out. Like, it was laggy, and then it stopped altogether for about a second. Alright, so, let's go ahead and we'll go do the Chocobo quest first. Friends of a Feather. And then we'll go ahead and do the main story. So let's auto to quest location. It's actually really close, so that's nice.
What's the forecast?
Clear skies with the temperature rising.
Nice.
It's only about a 1 minute car ride away, so not bad. The Stand By Me song did get copyright claimed, but it didn't get copyright striked, so that's good. So I can leave it in the video.
Is Ebony really all that good?
I might have answered before, but yes, it is.
But I'll be interested to see, because in the final cutscene, it's just completely the song. There's no voices, there's nothing else. So I'm interested to see if that gets copyright striked. If it does, I'm going to be disappointed. But I wanted to rewatch the ending because I enjoy the ending of this game. And there were a couple people that didn't have the music. But I did find a couple that did, so I doubt if some people do, it copyright strikes. It probably just copyright warnings you. And the people who cut the music out didn't want to lose the ad revenue. But I want the music in, so hopefully I will be allowed to do that. I make a save at the beginning of every one of these episodes in case something goes catastrophically wrong with the recording or something like that. I can always reload the save. So I'll do that, obviously, before the final episode, so if do get a copyright strike warning before I make the video public, I can just cut that out and redo the whole episode. But we are here at the Chocobo post. Gonna unlock our Chocobos. I did not ride the Chocobos a lot in like my 38 hours of initially playing this. I didn't ride them too much, and my like call was like glitched. It wouldn't let me call my Chocobo once I got off it for a while, and then it finally got itself fixed, but that kind of ruined the whole Chocobo thing for me. But let's go get these bad boys unlocked.
The kids got it bad.
They're a what?
Excuse me. We'd like to ride the Chocobos.
The Chocobos, huh? I hate to break this to y'all, but we can't permit our birds to leave the post. Not while Deadeye's still about. He's an uncommonly ferocious behemoth that's taken to prowling these parts of late. His scent makes our birds nervous, and to prevent accidents and tragedies, we have no choice but to suspend rentals. But hold on now. Ain't you lads the hunters that have been making a mark? You reckon you could handle the likes of Deadeye? If you could bring the beast down, there'd be a reward in it for you. But knowing the danger, I wouldn't blame you for saying no.
Alright, so we need to go hunt Deadeye. It says join the hunt. Do I need to talk to him again?
What'll it be today? Grab some grub before you go?
Okay, let's do this. Let's unlock all these marks on the map. Alright, there we go. And
my birds have all got their feathers ruffled.
Is it this? Yeah, here it is. Behemoth Undertaking. Go ahead and take that quest. This is kind of a
grub it is. What can I get you?
Let's go ahead and we'll just leave it.
Out there.
This is kind of a main quest of its own. It's like kind of a priority side quest. It has It has its own cutscenes and stuff like that. So we will go ahead and do this in this episode and then call it a video. I think that'll make a good video. Be a little longer.
They make tracks. Chop chop, Prompto.
There in a jiffy!
I don't like how this area is designed. There's like a certain area you're supposed to come in at. It's all the way on the other side over here. And then there's a lot of, like, slipping through cracks. There's even a stealth part to this. Which, stealth in this game, like, I get it. Like it's nice to have a stealth mission in your game, it's cool. But this game...
Something's amiss.
But stealth in this game is rough. And they always compound it and make it harder than it really has to be. And always when you're doing a fight these, there's a lot of them. And when you do stealth in a game where you have a party and you have an AI, it always is weird because you can't have the whatever you're stealthing from. It can't be alerted by the AI. That would just be unfair to the player. Because the AI isn't smart enough to hide with you. So it always looks kind of stupid, in my opinion. Alright, get off of me. Alright, let's go ahead and mark with Ignis. But you'll see, if you haven't seen it before, this does get a little wonky with the stealth here coming up. I don't know what's hitting me. I held X to block and nothing came. There's one that's really weak. Did they get it? I think they got it.
I'll say I'm amazed.
What can I say? Alright. We're done here.
Alright, stealth is coming up here. Might actually be around this corner. Nope, not quite yet. Here we go, we're coming up to it. This is a nice part, I do like this part, it's cool.
Knock.
He's glowing. Real question is, how on earth would he not hear you or smell you? You're right under his nose. You are like point blank under his nose. And I think Noctis is on his good eye. You know what, before I get too far with this, let me check my gear. Let me put on carbon bangle. And give him the garnet bracelet, there we go. Yeah.
It's weak on the right. No eye, no horn.
We'll stay in range until we can exploit its blind spot.
Alright. Where is the stealth? It makes you think he's gonna be right here. Like, your camera gets forced up there. I don't know what that's about. But it really wants your camera to look up there like he's gonna be there. I wonder if in...
Exercise due caution.
I wonder if previous design of the game he was gonna pop up over that wall and they chose not to do it. Okay, so this isn't a normal... here's the stealth part.
But no plan of attack. The behemoth should be headed back to its lair, where we can catch it fully off guard.
Yeah, as long as we stay on guard ourselves.
Alright, follow Deadeye back to his lair, do not let him see you, and do not lose his trail. What they failed to tell you, I believe, is that if you get seen, it's an automatic... Yeah, here we go. Deadeye senses your presence, drop back or take cover behind rocks. I believe if he sees you, you auto-fail. And as you can see here, they drop everybody out of your party. Because, obviously, the AI will probably get seen by him, so... They drop him out. Now, I always had problems with this, because there's no rock close. So you literally have to... You have to get to this rock here. This is the rock you want to get to. And he runs like this figure eight pattern here. He doesn't actually go to his den, because you come back to this rock, I believe. Then there's a nice rock up here. Right, sorry if you guys heard my phone, I switched to turn the volume off. Just getting an update for baseball. Is it that Aroldis Chapman signed? Back with the Yankees. Alright, where's the rock? Oh, it's over. I think this is the rock. There's the rock. Okay, so I wanted to go to that rock, not the rock I was at. I usually put my phone on mute. Actually, my phone's like always on mute. I don't know why the volume was on right there. I wish you could fight him in the smoke here, or in the fog here. It would be... Oh, God, I forgot. I forgot this is where he wraps around. But he's an idiot, so... See, he's going back. He literally just came and walked around this rock for fun, and then now is heading back. It's literally just something they put in the game to organically make... Or to... not organically, to purposely make this longer than it needed to be. Because they wanted you to have to stealth. I can see him. He's right there. How am I too far back? Alright, am I close enough for you now, game? Like I was saying, usually I have my phone muted, like, all the time. Not just, like, for videos. I have it muted all the time. So I was surprised when it went off. It was pretty quiet, though, so you guys might not have heard it. That's enough about my phone. See? He could have just taken the easy, direct route. Instead, he has to meander around every rock. I think we're getting close. What on earth was that camera angle, dude? Okay, there we go. You have discovered Deadeye's lair. Sneak through the stones. Okay. That camera angle was weird. Okay, we get to have a celebratory hop. Because We can't simply walk through this like a normal person. And we're back with our friends.
Day's work.
Alright, we got a little fire here, which is nice. And I already know that I need the fire, which you should know that you need the fire, since it pretty much tells you right there. What am I doing? Fire. Prompto, give him the circular saw. And let me put that axe on. I think it's better than this by a lot, isn't it? Yeah, this axe is one of the best weapons. Let me go ahead and equip that. Get on down here. Alright, party time. That roar needed to be a lot louder than it was. What was that? I didn't even notice that the first time. That was pathetic. What? That didn't blow it up? Oh my gosh, dude. Dude, he ran hella far away. Deadeye, what are you doing? What is he doing, dude? What is going on here? Dude, what is this? He's literally glitched. I'll unglitch him. Alright, come here. No, come here. Keep coming. Keep coming. No. Either come here or stay still. He's being a... You!
Keep it together.
There we go. A lot of damage for that, but... Alright, let's mark him. Start this out with this. I'm gonna go through everybody's abilities anyway. Go immediately into Piercer. And now Gladiolus. I'm gonna try to kite him back over here. Come here. Get over here. Thank you. What are you doing? Really, right when my fire recharges, you're gonna run? Come here. Come here. Swing. Or not. Whatever. Okay, somehow we both missed. Okay, we do this. I'm running low on health. I need to pay attention. And Gladiolus is way too far away. Right. Okay, hold up. Potion. Mark. Probably not the smartest to mark, but I'm gonna mark anyway. Is he on? It's hard to tell sometimes. I don't think there's one. Alright, guys, come over here. Come here, Deadeye. Get over here. Ah, you dick. Come on, come on, come on, buddy. Get back over here on the fire. Or run away like a pansy. Where is he going? Dude, what is this? Where is he going? Bro, what are you doing? I'm out of fire, hold up. Hold up, am I gonna die? And Dude, he's being such a dick, dude. Just get. Really, dude.
Look alive.
Can't even get up.
Bit of more than we can chew.
I should. Oh my god. I'm like 2 seconds away from just saying F it to trying to get him on one of these to blow him up. Dude, he's just gotta be such a dick monkey. Suck on that!
Let's finish this.
Show no mercy.
Gladly.
Alright, let's head back. That was a lot. I made that a lot harder than it had to be. I should have just fought him instead of messing around with throwing the fire. Because there's really no point to do it more than once, because I think you can just fight him more efficiently if you're not messing around with that. But we got the job done. That's all that really matters. But we'll go ahead and turn this quest in and call it an episode. A little bit longer of an episode than I expected, but not too bad. Alright, let's go turn this bad boy in so we can rent some chocobos.
You boys did it. You took down Deadeye. The area's safe again and we owe it all to you. On behalf of the locals, I give you my heartfelt thanks.
So, about the chocobos?
Our birds are at your disposal. You can rent them anytime you like.
There we go. Hunt complete.
Pretty tough customers.
Ooh, nice. 3,000 gil and an amethyst bracelet.
Woohoo! Come on, Noct. Let's go for a ride.
Ooh, that's some nice experience for friends of a feather. Chocobos are now available for rental. Also got my chocobo whistle. Can I pick this up? Alright, let's go ahead and... Is there some ways to sleep? Yeah. Let's go ahead and... Actually, no. We're going to meet Iris and Lestalem anyway. That's the good resting point, so we're not going to do that here. But that's going to do it for this episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I will catch you all in the next episode. Peace out.